G'day guys, Dylan Sfrenny here and welcome back to Marble Mountain. Super fun episode today. I only planned for this to be a very short one, but classic me just got really into it and decided that, you know what, stuff it, let's just make this a full-blown episode. It's one of those things where I thought it was going to take a very short time just to do, you know, drag a couple of train lines here and there and plop down some very generic looking train stations. I ended up just going detailed and getting really into the work that I do. So most of this is going to be time lapse. Around the 20 minute mark we'll go into a live play, so if you just want to see what I get up to, then you can just shoot on over to the end of the video, but you should totally stick around because the work that we do is pretty fun, and I talk about a couple of things that I'll need your input to. So today we're going to be beginning the process of connecting up all of Marble Mountain to the capital city, which is Montana. For those of you who are new to the channel, to the series, basically this is my series that I'm basing on the basically the whole California region, trying to squeeze as much into this map as possible, and I'm going to be talking about this in much greater detail in the next episode, which is an absolute doozy of an episode. But in a nutshell, I'm trying to squeeze in so many different towns and so many different climates, and part of that is to connect everything up so everything's working super smooth and everybody is happy with services and can get to the city, and also doing lots of driving videos as well. So, you know, we've started doing a couple of those, and I'd love to do some videos of taking journeys through the desert into the city and all the different climates and environments and towns you go through as you get there. Man, we're getting into some very exciting territory. I'm loving this so much at the moment. So, we are going to be working on some train lines. Now, I am working with sort of like pre-existing lines, but a lot of this I now need to sort of set up for a better passenger service, because we don't have any passenger services between these towns at the moment. So, the towns that I'm talking about, far out in the desert, we have, Chinchilla. That's the first town we're going to start in. Then we have this unnamed town that we will have to name at some point, but we're going to be working on that very shortly. Then we have Sabine, which is a town in the swampland. We have Copper Falls, which is a farming town, which is just outside of Montana, the capital. And then we have our big capital city, Montana, which is where the train service will terminate at this stage. Eventually, it'll just go everywhere. You can sort of see the scope of this whole project, can't you? So, the idea is to connect it up with a passenger service that I'm basing it off very loosely off Amtrak, which is a passenger service in the United States. I think it might be a service that just targets California, but I could be wrong there. Not much of a train guy, just like them. Feel free to correct me and point me in the right direction in the comment section below. And I have to admit, I started building this train line with just sort of thinking, all right, I'll just place down some stations and call it a day, that'll be it. But really, it became such a process of figuring out the best way to get people to these towns, also in ways that I thought was like somewhat realistic, but you know, I'll talk a bit more about that shortly. And I also wanted it to do a very classic 2020 style. I wanted the train line to do some very interesting and cool features, so that it's not just like going through a tunnel. Because obviously the easiest way to get people around would just be like having giant tunnels. But that's not fun. We want to see these trains. We want to see them going in and out these towns. We want them weaving in and out of the environment and going over bridges, you know, doing all that cool stuff. That's the whole reason why we're playing this game in the first place. So it's sort of based on realism, trying to make it work like functionally, but then I was also just trying to, you know, make things happen in a cool way. So what I'm using as the train stations to start things off. So this is where I'm just gonna plop down train stations and that'll be fine. But then I end up changing all these train stations to a more custom build. I changed them to train stations by Legio, which I'll also talk about in a sec. But the ones that I started off with, these are train stations by Bad Peanuts. I love these train stations. That's why I chose them. I thought, you know, they come in a nice pack. There's these really great, you know, they can do some really cool bypasses with the trains as well, which I thought would be really cool. And I think the way that Bad Peanuts created them, I think that they fit really well with like the vanilla City Skylines style. You know, it's not like too detailed, because sometimes it can be a bit of a contrast between like super detailed things, and then what I'm going for is a somewhat vanilla-esque style of city. So I chose these ones. I thought they'd be the best use, but I end up changing them because I realized that the types of train stations around California, they don't look like this. So I realized, I think it might be Lancaster that I start looking at for inspiration. And I realized that the train stations are very basic. And I was also really surprised at the lack of service. I sort of expected there to be stations throughout all these towns that stretch all the way around California, but there's only really a few of them that really get that service. Now, I could be wrong, like maybe I don't notice these stations, or maybe it's a good service, like maybe it is, you know, targeting the towns that are probably the most populated, of course, but I was just sort of like expected to see stations at every single stop or every single state, every little town, and I didn't. And I sort of thought, well, okay, I guess that's where mine's going to be different, because it pretty much stops at every single town in Marble Mountain, because of course that's way more fun. But it wasn't until I placed down these stations I thought, you know what, maybe they don't really fit that well within this map. I think they're brilliant stations and I plan on using them in other series, but I just think that if we're trying to build something based on California, I could actually find something that's a little bit more custom. So I end up creating some more custom style train stations. These are by Lejo. They're really fantastic. I think is adding more to this pack as well. And you can kind of build really complex big stations, which I don't really do in this episode. I just sort of focus on more smaller town, small based train stations, because you know we are sort of working in smaller towns. And yeah, I just think they work much better within this context. So you'll see me place them down and end up replacing all of them a little bit down the track. So, down the track, get it? Oh man, I do so many puns on these things. It's not on purpose either. So the first station that we started playing with, this station I'm playing with right now, this is the station in Chinchilla. And this station probably isn't in the most realistic location. It's sort of out of the town. I did that because it's kind of big and the town's fairly small, so I sort of thought, you know what, if we place it within the town, I'm gonna have to change a lot of the town, and I didn't really want to do that. So the position of it's not that realistic. It probably should be more heart and center of the town, but you know, that's, I think it's fine. So it sits over there in the corner. It was probably some sort of addition to the town. This town probably wasn't centered around the train station, and it was probably put in when the town expanded up a little bit. But to be honest, the town is fairly small, though the station gets a fair bit of use because a lot of people are working within the city, and they are also coming out this way to visit some of the parks for some reason. I don't know why anybody is leaving Montana to go and visit a park in Chinchilla, but I'm not questioning it. That's fine, as long as people are using the service. So the next station, we end up skipping past that town we're going to do in the desert. We're going to work on that at some stage, probably in about 3 or 4 episodes time. Can't bloody wait, it's going to be amazing. So I just skipped that one because I think we'll work on that a little later on down the track. The next station we're going to be working on is a station in Sabine. So Sabine is a very swampy little village just outside of Montana, and it sits near this this swampland that we've been working on over the last couple of weeks. And this town again probably doesn't really need a train station, but again, like, of course we're going to put a train station here because it's more fun if we do. And I end up placing out a couple of things that I end up deleting because I end up building a totally different train station. So everything you see me to work on right now, it actually gets deleted, but I decided to leave it in the time lapse because I've got a lot to talk about and it's still kind of interesting to see. I don't know, you let me know if seeing deleted builds is interesting. Maybe it's not, but to me it kind of is. So again, these train stations, bloody love them. I think they're amazing. I do want to use them in other series, but you can sort of see that it's just a little bit too grand and a bit too big for a little town like Sabine. I don't think it really needs a station this size. So I think that's where it really doesn't fit in with this, because you know, you've only got these ones to choose from. And I don't really want the train station just to be like the focal points for this area. If anything, I wanted to just blend in really naturally to the rest of the environment. So the ones that I do end up building, pretty much custom built ones, yeah, you'll notice they're a little bit more hidden, not so not so big. And I guess that this station, again, isn't really in a realistic location. It probably would be more heart center. You know what? Now that I think about it, I don't think any of the stations are in a position that is the most realistic spot. Most stations are in the middle of a town, which makes sense. Whereas, because I've already built the towns and they weren't built around train stations, or they weren't built with a train line going through the heart of it, they don't really fit. So, unfortunately, people are having to drive to the station or do like a pretty big walk to get there. The residents of Bine, they're fine because the towns are very big, but a place like Copper Falls, it's a little bit out of the way, so I feel sorry for them. Although, I guess this one isn't really that out of the way, but it's kind of like right next to these crops and on the highway too. It does make for some pretty eye candy shots of the train station as you are driving to and from Montana from the highway. So that's a plus. That's like a plus for me, because that's all I really care about is how eye candy these things are. Less about the realism, probably more about the eye candy. And because we do have this train station here, it was really hard to figure out how I was going to get this this train line or this service to go to the go to Montana, because it actually wasn't connected up in that direction. So I had to drag this one as a tunnel. I really didn't want to do that. I really wanted to avoid tunnels, because I just think it's a waste. To be honest, I think it's a bit of a waste of, it's a bit of a waste of scenery. I think, you know, if it did like a cool bridge over the top, that would have been way better, but there's literally no space to do it. I'll talk more about that in the live play. So, unfortunately, you had to just drag that tunnel, and I think that works fine. It means that people can actually get there. And something else that I really wanted to make sure that I wanted there to be no trains getting banked up. You know how they just form that massive conga line, and I mean, hopefully, fingers crossed, I've done the train line in a way that it avoids that from happening, and I plan on reducing the amount of trains that'll be in service, or, you know, just like minimizing the budget so that we don't have too many trains. Because otherwise they do get pretty banked up if you have a lot doing a particular service. I'll talk more about that in the live play too. So we are finally now starting to replace the train stations with these new ones by Lejo. I believe he's basing them off Amtrak, or at least the service within the United States. So these are like American style train stations, which again fits in probably better with what I'm going for. And the way that he's designed them as the assets is that they're basic, they're stripped of everything. You don't have anything to go off. You have to sort of create your own type of train station and hub, and, you know, all the props that go on top of it as well, which I actually quite like. It means that you can make it a little bit more custom as well. So we've just got the basic platform here, and I decided to use a one-way track you have to use a one-way track. But it works really well, because then the trains that are using the train station will then use this one-way track to access it. And then all the other trains that are just, whether they're interstate trains, like going completely off the map, only going to the downtown, they will just bypass it, which is really good. I've just spawned in, well, I didn't spawn in. I connected up a train to see if it stretches along the platform in the right way, and where all the carriages are going to go, because there's nothing worse than building something like a custom build like this and then watching it go in action and it just doesn't fit. That's so, like, I've played this game for like 3 years now and I still make that mistake constantly. So just made sure that the train fits up well, and now that I know where the train is actually going to be stretched, I can then start placing down the props in where I think is the most realistic area. So using just some benches, I'm using these custom rooftops as well. I think that might be again by Lejo. I've also got some custom billboards that were created by my beautiful people on Discord and my audience. So you guys, a whole bunch of people created some custom billboards for Marble Mountain, and they look great on this train station. So yeah, that looks awesome. Fences as well, and I've also got some extra props of platform too that I can just sort of make it fits a little bit better, a little bit bigger, a little bit wider station. And that's pretty much it. It kept it really raw, really basic, because that's the sort of like style of the train stations in California. or at least the type of train station that I'm going for, that fit in with these sort of towns. It doesn't make any sense to build anything too massive or too flash in a town like, or any of the towns that we end up building in. Also, I'm using one of the King Leno buildings that he created for the, I believe it was the Campus DLC. It's like a prop, a building pack, and man, the buildings are incredibly versatile. I know he created them so that they were really versatile. There's barely any props on them. They have, only some of them have signs on them, and because they are so versatile, and because they are just so, I mean, they're bland in a good way, means that you can actually make them into any type of building you want. So I actually placed down some similar buildings within the zoo that we created last episode, and right now I'm using it as the train station entrance, like the administration building, which is just awesome. And I ended up using this model, like this base of platform that I create here for Copper Falls. I ended up placing that, I'm using the same design in Sabine, and I'll also use the same design in Chinchilla. Because, I mean, quite often train stations will all look the same anyway. And particularly in like these smaller towns, they don't really need to make some massive, big, unique building for what is just a very plain and ordinary service. Though, in saying that, and this is going to trigger a lot of people's memory from an old series, it was an old collaboration by Strict Toaster and Flux Trans and Fresh Popcorn. I end up placing down the Arrowhead Junction train station that they used in that series. Let me know if you watched that series, because that was like one of the series that pretty much kickstarted my YouTube channel. I saw that and I thought, you know what, maybe I can give this thing a go. And yeah, like, here we are today, three years later, far out. So yeah, we ended up placing that down, and when I even placed it, I was like, oh man, this is bringing back some memories. This is bringing back some really nice memories. And I might have binged watched a couple of the episodes while I was building this too, but don't tell them, because I don't want that to go to their heads. So yeah, the train station looks so good in that location. It's going to really make for a really cool and unique town. Would love some suggestions for this town that we end up building. It's going to be awesome. I can't wait. But what I am doing at the moment, I'm placing down the train station in Sabine, and you can just see that it just fits in a lot better. It means that I can sort of keep a little bit more low-key. It means that I can have the shops around the main entrance of the train station too, which I wasn't able really to do because the other train station was just a little bit too wide. So, you know, just creating a little bit of a custom car park, and we've got some other buildings that I'm just sort of placing down, but keeping the general detail work very low-key around here. Yeah, but it's amazing that, like, only just changing a couple of things of this station, and even just the props and buildings and trees and stuff around it, it makes it still quite unique and different to the one that we built in Copper Falls. And look, you'll be able to see a lot better in detail in the live play, but yeah, it looks great. I think it looks really cool there. So now we're getting into the train station for Chinchilla. Same location, just a different station. There you go, there's a bit of a rhyme for you. Doing puns and rhymes in this commentary. Must be a real good one. Yeah, so this station is very, very similar to the Copper Falls one. I don't change too much. You know, again, when we start building in this area a little bit more and start detailing up these sort of areas, then we can sort of get into the nitty-gritty of what goes where and how everything's going to look. But for the time being, I just think, you know, it's fine. It's far enough away from Copper Falls to really even notice that it's that similar. And I think changing, you know, adding some fences and putting in some shrubs, and even the types of shops that I place around here, I put like a little burger store that's just like so tiny. I think it's like 2x2, and I've just sort of connected it up and barely any detail. It's great. I really love it. Coming towards the end of the time lapse now, and I am placing down the Arrowhead Junction train station. We'll detail this bad boy up in future episodes, not far away. But let's get into the live play so I can talk about everything that we've been up to. Man, it is honestly so satisfying watching these trains go through Marble Mountain. I've probably spent like 40 minutes just flying around. It's awesome. So, I should give you a bit of a tour of all the places we worked on. It's somewhat substantial, but we've also got a lot to do. So basically, like, this is all a Marble Mountain, and I want there to be commuter trains going everywhere, and stations pretty much wherever there is a town. We have Chinchilla, which is where we're going to start our train journey. Then we have this unnamed town, which we're going to build in about 3 or 4 episodes' time. We have Sabine, we have Copper Falls, and then we have Montana, of course, where it terminates. But, like, that is just scratching the surface. We plan to do towns everywhere else, where I'll talk a bit more about that in a bit. First up, I want to show you where it starts and where it finishes. Where is this train? Uh-huh. Yeah, great. Okay, cool. Perfect timing. So, like I said, the train station in Chinchilla is kind of out of the city, or out of the town, I should say. Look, I think that's fine, because, I mean, I want Chinchilla to be somewhat small, and I think if I was to put the train station here, then it interrupts these roads, and if I put it, over here, that doesn't really make much sense. So I think, like, placing it in a location like this, although it is out of the town, I think this is going to make more sense in the long run. This road here is going to extend out, and we'll probably do something else with this, maybe a couple more, like, little farmlands around here, but, I think it might terminate somewhere around here. Who knows? So, like I said, fair bit of people coming into Chinchilla, which is kind of unusual, but, you know, not complaining. I actually really love this part of the train's journey, just, like, cutting through the town here, and I think it just does some really interesting things that I am really happy about. And just here as well, I don't know if you saw this in the time lapse, but, like, so awesome. We're going to be doing lots more of this, and we need to fix that train. And then the train goes through some very undetailed areas, which we're going to work on all these places down the track. And here is just a little bit of a flashback. If any of you guys watched Arrowhead Junction by those legends, well, yeah, here we have the Arrowhead Junction train station. Even says Arrowhead Junction there. This is Arrowhead. So I think that's going to fit in really nicely in this location. There's going to be this, like, town that's going to sit here. This will be somewhat in the middle, but, you know, we'll see how that all pans out. So, we then have a journey. This is going to be, like, a fairly, hilly sort of area. I plan to do these sort of hills coming out of that town. And, the train will probably end up cutting down below it or above it. We're not going to do any tunnels or anything like that. But basically, this is like its journey from the desert into what is like a more temperate environment as it goes across this swampland. Although, like, of course, swampland isn't the sort of environment you'd expect straight after a desert. For transition's sake, I think that's fine. We might need to control a little bit of the speed on these trains, because I think that's a bit too fast on a bridge like that. So we now have Sabine Station. This is a station that I didn't put a hell of a lot of work into, but I think what I did do, I quite like. Fair amount of people getting off here. They're probably going to places like the parks and other areas like that. Oh, okay, no one's getting off. Probably people are going to get off when they come from the main city to come here. But look, Sabine is, it's not that nice. It's not a nice town. So we've got, like, piles of trash. You know, this is sort of classic stuff you usually see next to train stations and little pathways and, you know, the outskirts of towns. You don't expect, you know, the nicest of areas. You know, quite often you see, like, dumping areas and, you know, the transition from nature to what is introduced species, which is what you typically see around, like, neighborhoods and suburbs and stuff. So, it goes there, like I've just explained. We have here Randy Marsh, this little town, but I don't think it deserves a train station. Sorry, residents of Randy Marsh, but I just think that you're probably just a little bit too small of a town to really need some sort of train station. But the train, oh, it's gone already. But basically the train snakes around here behind this farm that we built in a live stream, actually. Past this little area, at the back of a lot of these farms. And here we have Copper Falls Station. A fair bit of people live in Copper Falls, so you can expect a fair bit of people trying to get into the city. Even a couple of people leaving, which is, you know, that would make sense. Like, I think there would be people who live in Sabine, work in Copper Falls. There is like a bit of a town in here. Some shops and stuff, so yeah. I can imagine that. So, I quite like this little station. I think it's great. I even like the location of it. Yeah, we'll control some of these speeds. I'm glad they're not doing anything glitchy around here. I mean, that's not perfect, but, you know, whatever. City Skylines, guys, what can you do? Okay, I had a bit of trouble here. So, basically, the problem was is that the line snaked its way around here, and then there was another line that went this way. Now, the problem is that we didn't have a line going into the city, and I just didn't think about that when I first designed this area. So we had to create this new line that goes through this tunnel, which I'm not thrilled about. I much prefer to have some sort of, above ground thing going on. But with this interchange here and the way that the mountain is on this side, we just couldn't really get away with basically not doing a tunnel. So we had to do a tunnel. That's fine. The tunnel's fine. So it comes back up. Now, I love this little section here because it snakes its way across where the thingo is, the highway. That's what I'm trying to say. And, like, it picks up some speed. Maybe we might have to reduce that speed. But this is cool because, like, it's a bit of a transition from what is, like, farmland and then we're going into the city. This is pretty much done, this area. Like, I'm pretty happy. How good's that? I'm pretty happy about how all this looks. And with the train line going through, I think it's just awesome. So the train line then comes through here. Man, I think I turned down the graphics a little bit too hard. Yeah, look at that. Don't you love that? Beautiful. But it does come along here, and we need to work on this area. This is what I thought I was going to get this far in this episode, but you can see I'm really past 20 minutes. We're not going to get any further. There is just one line coming along here, but we do need something to go this way, and the train does a pretty slow crawl to the main terminal, and people pop up around here, I believe. So that's the journey. That's the routes that we have so far, and a lot of people are making their way into the greater region, which is fantastic. There they are. And I wonder what they're up to. What are you doing? Okay. And you going home, and you going to school. Yeah, this is great. You know, like, beautiful. So, people are using the service, which is great. That's what we wanted. Whoa. Okay. We are out of the city. We are in the sky. What I wanted to talk about is where it's going to go next. Look, that's just one line. That's it. I want the connection to go here, and I want there to be a town here, and there's going to be like the second biggest town of Marble Mountain is going to go here, and it's going to be pretty much like Las Vegas. So there's going to definitely be a line here. And look, the way that it's all connecting up at the moment, it is all making sense. We already have a train line here, we have a train line over here, and we have some connections getting ready, like this one already it's already over here. So, in terms of the passenger service expanding, it's going to be pretty flawless. The only drama I have is the next line going over here because we actually have no train lines. So, I don't know. I don't know whether... I mean, and this is where I'd love your opinion, whether you've made it this far into the episode. But basically, we do have a train line here. We could extend it out across the bay like this. Let me know what you think. Should we do that or should we not? Would love your opinion. We're ages away from doing that. We're going to probably focus on some bigger projects in the next episode. And by probably, I mean we are. This whole section in the next episode is going to be changed. I know that because I've already done it. So, next couple of episodes are massive ones. Actually, you know what? The next, like, month and a half in Marble Mountain are going to be some pretty big episodes. So, get excited for that. But today's episode's pretty much finished. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Much appreciated. I hope you've enjoyed it. And until next time, have a great week, and I'll see you in the next video. See ya.